necklace, you'll need 4 faceted labradorite nugget beads. These are really lovely and kind of irregularly cut. Ours are generally 12 millimeters by 14 millimeters. And then you'll need 5 faceted rondelle beads. These are silver and they're 6 millimeters by 11 millimeters. You'll use a lobster clasp or any kind of clasp you want. Ours is a lobster. It's silver and it's 12 millimeters. And for the other end of the necklace, we're going to use a jump ring that's silver and it's 5 millimeters. We're also going to use chain in this project. This is sort of a flat oval link chain, and we measured the chain. It's about 4 millimeters wide. We also have 2 crystal bicones that are silver to match the rondelles. Those are 4 millimeters. And we're going to put it together with 22 gauge wire in silver. For tools, we have chain nose pliers, we have round nose pliers, and we have wire cutters. To make the necklace, the first thing you want to do is cut 2 lengths of chain 4.5 inches each. And to cut the length of chain, we just cut right through one of the lengths and you throw that one away. And then that's how you get your smaller piece of chain. So we have 2 pieces that are 4.5 inches long each. Then we're going to start doing the center of the necklace, which is done with wire work. This is our 22 gauge wire in silver. I'm going to cut a piece that's about, I don't know, 3 or 4 inches long. I like to use a long piece for wire work more than I need. And what we're going to do is we're going to start by making a wrapped loop in one end of this piece of wire. The tool for that is the round nose pliers, and I'm going to come almost halfway down the wire. And I'm going to bend this wire. It's a little curvy from being in the roll. I'm straighten it out a little bit. But I'm going to bend the wire 90 degrees like that. So it was about halfway down. There's our 90 degree bend. Then I'm going to reposition the pliers to the top of that 90 degree bend like that. I'm going to push the wire over. This is going in the opposite direction from the bend, over the top jaw of the pliers. I'm making a loop for this component, but the wire can't go all the way around because the bottom jaw is in the way. So I reposition so the bottom jaw is in that loop. And now I can pull the wire around the rest of the way. Now before I wrap that and make it a wrap loop, I want to hook it into the end of my chain. So what you do is just pick up one of the pieces of chain and we're going to slide on the last link and nestle it into that loop, just like that. Now I can do the wrap that we want for a wrap loop. So to do that, I can use either my chain nose pliers now or my round nose pliers and hold the loop across and then pull the end here, this tail, around the neck. That's what we call these parts. Pull that tail around 2 times. And this is a little bit harder wire. And if you're having trouble pulling it around, you can use your chain nose pliers to give a better grip and pull it tighter to make a tighter wrap loop. That's our wrap loop hooking into one end of the chain. And now I want to cut the wire, trim that little end. I'm going to use the flat side of the wire cutters. I'm going to hold on to both parts of the wire so it doesn't fly off and just trim that. And if you have a little end sticking out, I only have a tiny end there, but just for good measure, you can press that little end down with your chain nose pliers like that. So that's the beginning of our wire work section. Chain on one side. And the first bead we're going to start with is one of the rondelles. This will alternate between the rondelles and the labradorites. So this first one that's next to the chain is one of these silver faceted rondelles. And what we're going to do now is make another wrap loop like this one on the other side of that rondelle. To do that, I'm going to do the same thing we did before. I'm going to pinch the wire next to the bead. I'm way out at the end of my pliers, so I'm not adding a lot of slack in there. But I'm going to pinch the wire and make a 90 degree bend, and then move to the top of the bend. Pull that wire around like that. Reposition so my bottom jaw is in there, and pull it around. And this time I don't have anything to hook this through yet. It's going to hook through the next component, but I haven't made my next component yet. So for this one, I'm going to go ahead and do my wraps. and I grab that tail. I'm going to use my chain nose pliers for this. Grab that tail and pull that around two times. One and two. That makes a nice tight wrap like that. It makes a funny end on the other end, but that's a throwaway piece of wire anyway. And I can reach in now and trim that piece of wire like that. And again, I can just bend that little wire down a tiny bit. There's our first component of the necklace. It looks like this with the bead on the wire and then attached to the chain. Now we're going to make another component just like this one, and we're going to hook it through that first component. So for that, I've got another piece of wire. It's about 4 inches long, and I come about halfway down with my round nose pliers and make a loop. To do that, I do the 90 degree bend, just straightening the wire out a little bit there. There's my 90 degree bend, reposition to the top, push that wire up and over in the opposite direction to make a partial loop, reposition my bottom jaw of my pliers in so I can finish that loop, pull it around like that. Now I can take this loop and slide it through our first component loop like that. Just pull that up through. And now I've got the two connected, and now I wrap that loop. I'm looking at the size of the loop I made. The first loop is a little bit smaller here than this one. I'm going to reach in with my pliers, and I'm just going to pull this wire a little bit to make that loop a tiny bit smaller, like that. And one thing you can do is put a mark on your pliers, like here, and then try to make all your loops on the same part of the pliers so they'll all be the same size. That's a little tip. So now I'm holding that loop across, and I can pull the tail around. It really does pull around better with the chain nose pliers. Let me grab these chain nose pliers. I'm going to pull this around two times. It just feels like I'm getting a nice tight pair of wraps when I do it with the chain nose pliers. And now we trim that piece of wire. Like that. And then the next bead that we're going to put on, we already have the silver rondelle. So next one is going to be one of these chunky faceted labradorite nuggets. Isn't this beautiful? Labradorite has a little bit of fire in it. Because these are irregular, I have to figure out where the hole is. Here it is. Labradorite is like opal in that it has a little bit of fire inclusion in it. It has a sort of a blue cast inside that reflects a lot of light. It's really pretty. And now I'm going to make another wrap loop here, just past that bead. I'm going to make that 90 degree bend. I repositioned the pliers a little bit there, so I'm getting a little bit bigger loop by going up the pliers a tiny bit. Go around halfway, put the bottom jaw in, and I can pull around the rest of the way like that. There's my loop. And now I can take the chain nose pliers. Actually, I like using the chain nose pliers to pull the end around. I'm going to keep holding on with my round nose pliers. And we don't have another component to go through on this side yet. We haven't made it. So I can go ahead and finish this wrapped loop. And I'm going to pull this end around. That's one wrap. Pull it around the rest of the way. I'm making it look hard, but it's easy. Okay, there we go. And then I can reach in there and trim that wire. Just, you want to hold on to that little piece of wire so it doesn't fly off. Now we've got two pieces together. So I'm just going to keep on making these components. I'm going to make another rondelle one here, followed by a labradorite, all the way up until I'm ready to put on my last rondelle. I have one last component to make with the rondelle. I have my 4-inch piece of wire here. I'm going to grip it about halfway down with the round nose pliers, make a loop at one end, just like we've done for all our other components. I reposition to the top of that bend, make a partial loop, reposition my bottom jaw of my pliers to make the rest of the loop, pull that around, and this loop gets fastened to our necklace, the last open link there. You have to kind of work it past the crisscross there. And now I can make my wraps. I like holding that loop across with the round nose pliers, and I'm gonna pull this tail around. I've been using the chain nose pliers with this wire. This is 22 gauge wire, which is a little bit thicker, and so it's a little bit harder to pull around. We like the weight of it though, because these are big beads. So we thought it would look a little too delicate to use very, very thin wire. I reach in with those flush cutters, cut that wire, and it always leaves a little bit of a tail for us. I think it's the thickness of the blades. So, but all you have to do is reach in and press that little tail down, which is a good habit anyway. And I've got my last bead here, which is the last silver rondelle. And I make my last little wrapped loop for this section. I pinch right above the bead, 90 degree bend, reposition to the top. I'm trying to slide my pliers in a little bit because I want the loop to be back here. I go over the top as a partial loop, reposition the bottom pliers in there. I have to kind of pull that wire around the rondelle, it's in the way. But now I've got a partial loop there. And this is my last loop, but I don't want to close it off because this is where the chain goes. This is how we're going to connect the necklace together. So I'm going to slide my other piece of chain onto that component and just push it past a little crisscross there so it's hooked in. And now, just like before, I can hold this loop across. Move the chain out of the way a little bit. Hold that loop across, and I can take my chain nose pliers, or you can use your fingers, and I can pull this wire around two times. Since the wire's a little bit stiff, but it looks so pretty. There we go. And the last step here on this wrap loop is to trim that wire again. I'm going to reach in there, holding the end of that wire so it doesn't fly off. And I'm trying to get as close as I can without cutting the project. There we go. And that one has just a tiny little tail sticking up. There's the center of the necklace. And you can see that we alternated between rondelles and labradorite chunks. And it just looks gorgeous. And now all we have to do is put on the clasp. The last thing we need to do for our necklace is put on the clasp. And to do that, we're going to make two more wire wrap components. And we're going to do them just the same. I'm cutting a piece of wire about 3 or 4 inches long. And what I want to do is I'm going to make a little component with this tiny bicone, and I'm going to use it to attach the lobster to the chain and the jump ring to the chain. So to make that wrap loop component, just like before, I come almost halfway down the wire and make a 90 degree bend, reposition the pliers, push the wire over the top of the round pliers. I'm letting the round shape of the pliers make that loop for me. I'm using them like a mandrel. There's my loop, and I don't want to wrap it off yet. I don't want to close it because I want to attach the chain here. I have to pull it past the crisscross. I just pull it a little bit. And when I did that, I misshaped my loop a little bit. I want to straighten that back out. There we go. And now I wrap the loop now that the chain is captured in the loop. And I'm going to use my chain nose pliers again and pull around, pulling this tail around the neck two times. It's helping me get tighter wraps and straighter wraps. I'm noticing that by using the chain nose pliers to pull that wire around. I'm going to reach in here and trim the end with my wire cutters, and then I'm going to press that tail down. It's that little end with my chain nose pliers. You could also do that at the end after you make your whole project. you can go back through and kind of examine it and make sure all those little ends are pushed down. So this component is going to have that cute little silver bicone on it. These other ones are nice and big and chunky, but this is at the back of the necklace where the clasp is, so we chose a small bead. And on the other side of the bead, I make another wrapped loop, just like before. 90 degree bend, and then reposition the pliers to the top of the bend, and then pull that wire around to make that loop. There's my loop. And before I wrap that loop off, I'm going to put my jump ring on it. This jump ring is going to be the end of our necklace and is going to form the other half of the clasp. I'm using my chain nose pliers to kind of pull it past that crisscross in the partial loop because sometimes my fingers are just getting in the way, and you can use your tools. So I just use my tools for that. And now I grasp across that loop and do my two wraps. I grab the end here of the wire with the chain nose pliers and pull. I'm kind of pulling kind of tightly here. Pull that around two times. And there's our little component. And I can reach in here with these wire cutters and trim that end. So there's one end. Oh, we got a little tail to push down. It's half a wire work is pushing those little ends down. That's fine. So that is one end of our necklace. That little bicone component, it's a very pretty finishing touch, and it's also a secure way to put this jump ring onto the chain. And we're just going to repeat that at this end. I've got about a 4-inch piece of the wire, and I'm going to pinch it about halfway down with my round nose pliers. Make my 90 degree bend. Oops, it's spinning in my hand. There we go. Make my loop over the top. Pull it around the bottom. And then feed the chain through so it's nestled inside that loop. Now I can do my two wraps here with my chain nose pliers. Grab the end, out here at the end, and do two wraps nice and tight like that. That may have been my best one. And then reach in with the pliers, the cutters, I mean, and trim that little end. And that one's actually not sticking up. See, this is my best component of the day. And there's our little bicone. And this will be my last wrapped loop. I'm going to pinch right on top of the bead, 90 degree bend, and then I reposition so I can push that wire over the top to make a partial loop. Reposition so my bottom jaw is in there to make the rest of the loop. And then before I finish that off, this is my last piece. This is my lobster clasp. And I'm going to feed that in. And I'm going to work it past the crisscross. There we go. So it's nestled in there. And now I can hold that loop across, just like before. And with my chain nose pliers, I can pull that wire around two times, like that. Move my chain out of the way. And then I'm going to reach in there and trim that little piece of wire. And then I can just latch the necklace like that. So that's what our clasp looks like with that beautiful little wire work with the bicones. And then if we go around to the other side, you can see this is our beautiful chunky gemstone necklace. So pretty.